last one, your money, is make speak to yourself. Speak to yourself. If you are to fan your desire, fan it into a flame. If you want to fan your desire into flame, don't stop talking about it. Speak to yourself like a crazy man. This is what I'm going to have. 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 If you want to buy a certain dress and you see it in a certain shop, visit it every day. When you knock off, pass by every day so that you are talking to yourself. If you are buying a car, check it every day. On the internet, every day look at it. Because speaking meditation, as what the tender said, in fact, meditation rises in you to a point where now it is no longer meditation. It becomes something that comes out in you in a subconscious. I say it becomes something which comes out of you, not out of your conscious decision. It means you have actually introduced it into a subconsciousness. I say when you talk, that now you can talk without thinking, without deciding. It means what you have done is that you have introduced that thing into a subconscious life. Why subconscious life? Because every time when God wants to work with you, He does not introduce it in our conscious life. He beholds it in your subconscious life, where you live without limitation, where even though you are a man without wings, but you can see yourself flying. He loves first to give it as a dream, not in a conscious life, but in a subconscious life. Because there is a possibility of your life. He introduces it where you have infinite world. Yes, without any limitation, no boundary, where you can walk on water, where you can actually have wings and fly. Then he shows you this is what you can get. He shows you all those things in that world, but he's actually enhancing you. That when you get into a conscious life, you can remember what you were able to do in your subconscious life, where nothing looked impossible. When you dodge, slot out, and still get to the place. And many of you, I'm talking to you now, you wish if you can have your subconscious life in this life, because in your subconscious life, that's where you cannot argue with God. He can tell you to jump an ocean and you say yes. You don't see it as an ocean. That's why when God wanted to introduce great way ever beginning to a man, he didn't want to talk to him in his conscience. He knew he's going to argue with this man. He had to wait him to sleep. In his subconscious, he says what he wants. Then Solomon says, give me something that will change. God says, I will give you what I've never given to any man. Even your father Abraham never had what I'm giving to you. When he came to his conscience, he believed Solomon and lived his dream of life. But many of you know, you have never seen yourself rich in your subconscious life. The reason is, you have never come to meditate that you have planted it into your subconscious. See if you meditate something strongly, that it will flow out of you without making a decision. It actually passes. If it sustains rather your consciousness, at that level you are such a powerful person.
And
people will remind you, will tell you later, say, this is what you said in a sense. You said, no, it wasn't me. Because you can easily suspend your consciousness, which has to be, you know, which obey the laws and the elements and all those things. God says, I don't want arguments here. So what we do here, let me first of all remain strong in his subconscious life, that when I bring it into his consciousness, at least it will have a memory that what I'm telling him to do is already possible. He has already seen in another life where there's no limitation. But what you do, talk to yourself that until that thing is planted and introduced into this subconscious, you come to that level, you will sleep and see yourself. Companies that you've never seen, you see divine ideas that no one has ever tried yet. When you wake up, you are ready to go up by it. But you see, you are all processing in this. You are processing in this consciousness. And you are conscious that you are a human being. You are conscious that this is Malawi. You are conscious that you are coming from a poor family. You are conscious that you are not educated enough. You are conscious that you don't have money and capital. But not in this other life. That you come in this life. And no one can stop you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that at that level, you are a dreamer. You are a dreamer now. At that level, and no one can stop you. No one can stop you. You know, you don't kill a dream. You can delay it, but you don't kill it. You don't kill it at
all.
You're called a dreamer. Praise God. That's why the Bible, you know, when brothers of Joseph came,
in
chapter 42, when the brothers came,
Genesis 42,
I said, you guys, you did this to me. The Bible says, he remembered the dream. And when he remembered the dream, he says, it's possible. Not to be angry. I don't need to be angry. This is how God planned. So, the dream in the subconsciousness helped him to make a better decision in his conscious life. He didn't see these people as enemies anymore, because God already enhanced him in his subconsciousness. Can you take your
hands?
Let the devil be a liar today. Let the devil be a liar today. Even there is no money in your dream yet. If there is no wealth in your dream yet. If your wealth is not introduced yet in you. If divine prosperity is not what you dream of. I am praying now.
Jesus.
See, now, yes. prosperity. God says to Joshua, if you shall meditate on my way, you shall have a good success. You shall be prosperous. Mighty name, we have trusted God, and we know it is done to our lives. It is done to our lives. In Jesus' name. Some years ago, I don't know whether 3, 4, 5 years ago, I can't remember. I'm finishing now. The Lord started causing us to dream. She could dream, I could dream. And amazingly, we couldn't share because it was about money. It was all about money. Everything about money. She could dream and in the morning she could say, hey, I saw this. Billions of money. I saw all these things were happening. And I could share. We went on for a season. By a season, I mean it was a couple of months. She could dream, I could dream. By the end of that season, I came to know that from this day on forth, I will never be a poor man. It will never be possible to have luck in this life. I'm telling you, after we went through that which God was trying to process, we knew that God is introducing something. And I said, from today, we will never lack in our life. There will never be a lack. So there is a reason why the Lord will put it in your dream. But don't wait for him to put it in your dream. You surrender yourself to what you desire. You can give yourself over and says, this is what I desire. This is what I desire, man. And God will honor you. Are you following what I'm saying? I wanted to go further with the testimonies, but I don't want to go to that extent. It's not important for now. So, the way, for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. The word will there, I think one time I told you, it's the word Pharaoh, T-H-E-R-O. And the reason why I'm telling you is because of the meaning of that word. It's very important. I'll be finishing with that word. That word Pharaoh, if you are reading the Bible, you find the word will has two are common. Two are very common. The third one doesn't appear, it's not much in the Bible. But these two, there is a word Pharaoh, which appears in many places. And there is another word which we call it in Greek, Bolmai. Bolmai. Okay? That word and this one, U-O, and Pharaoh will be we in English. But in the text,
Over degree.
It is not just a will. There is a difference. But mind is to wish. It is still going to be will in English. But it is simply deciding without pressing for an action.
That's
like, are you going to come with me? He may say yes. But he may not be determined to come with me. But he's willing. He may say yes. But you check inside of him. He's not determined for that. Well, fellow is not just making a decision. It's not deciding. It is deciding and pressing. You decide, you are pressing. And
are
you getting what I'm saying? That's how God works in you. When it comes to a life, He does not simply make you will. But it does a will in you that it becomes everything that you think of. It becomes everything that you desire in life, or what you think of. When God works the will in your life.
Now,
I'm finishing with this. I want you just to see this. In Acts chapter 19, verse 21. Acts chapter 19, verse 21. The Bible says, after these things,
were
ended.
See that.
Paul purposed. Can you say purposed?
Purposed.
It is in the spirit. Inside of him, he says, I have to do this. When he had passed through Macedonia and Achaia to go to Jerusalem. So he did not just say, I wish if I can go to
Jerusalem.
But in his
spirit.
After you've gone through this place, I will get to
Jerusalem.
This is my decision. Are you getting this? Now go to 20. Let's start from 22. Let's go to the second set, a chapter. 22. And now behold, I go bound in the spirit and
Jerusalem.
He says, not knowing the things which shall befall me there. I have no clue what's going to happen. He says in 23, save that the Holy Spirit is
divine
in every city that I'm going, that pains and affliction abide or are waiting for. What can you do if you hear about the Holy Spirit? Pains and affliction are waiting for. You praise God and say thank you. Thank you for telling me. Remember, it's the Holy Spirit that is investing in every city. Prophets will come and say, the man that I'm taking the peril, this is what they're going to do for him. But what they did at all, purpose. In verse 24, but none of these things move my life.
He
says, neither count I myself, my life dear to myself. All what matters to me is that I can finish the course with joy. Where would the course of his life going to end?